apologize for my dress. We just literally came off the field, and we're going to go back out in the field a little bit later this afternoon. It's all about Old Dominion first. You know, I thought Old Dominion gave us their A game. You know, I've seen every game they played this year. I thought they played about as well as they've played all season. And I thought our kids played about as well as they played all season. They looked like two pretty good football teams really battling it out there. You know, a couple opportunities we didn't get. You know, we had a potential pick six at the end of the half. We knocked out a ball on a kickoff return that we just couldn't come up with. So, you know, there were some opportunities that we let go. You know, I thought, and I said this after the game to the kids, is that we just need to play cleaner, especially in the second halves. It seems like we make some mistakes and we give up some things. And there's some opportunities that I think we all look at the videotape and just kind of shake our heads because I think we're a better football team than what we showed at times. I thought we played pretty well about 99% of the time, but boy, that 1%, we made some mistakes that kind of gave the game away. You know, Trent, you know, got beat up pretty good. You know, they got in his mask one time and Roy tore up his eye. There was a couple helmet-to-helmets that he had a lesser player, I don't think, comes back out and plays the second half. But you got to respect, you know, how hard he plays. He probably plays as hard as any player I've ever had. He hands the ball off to AP on a 45-yard run down the sideline for AP. I'm watching the tape, and all of a sudden I see 12 catching AP, running down the sideline trying to make a block. And here's a kid with a midfoot sprain. And I brought him in, I showed him that play, and I said, please stop doing that. Normally, you really appreciate that effort, but, I mean, he's just so banged up right now, you don't want to put himself in harm's way. You know, I think one of our offseason projects is going to be him throwing the ball away a little bit more and also possibly taking him over to Coach Sherman and seeing if we can teach him how to slide. Because he obviously doesn't know how to slide, and he doesn't know how to get up out of bounds. Unless he's driven out of bounds, then he knows how to go out of bounds. But maybe in my 20 years of coaching football, as hard as I've ever seen a team play, and the reason I say that is because if you look at all the guys who aren't coming off the field, I don't know how often Jeff Williams comes off the field. I don't know how often Jake Jesty comes off the field. Timmy Breaker, Ricky Tunstall. You know, so many guys, Pat Callaway, that are forced to play all the special teams and also start on offense or defense. It's kind of unusual because of all the guys we've lost in the secondary and the linebacker spot and now some running backs, those are the bodies that typically play special teams. So we've lost so many guys, but you also have to credit our kids for how well they played on special teams. We pinned the ball down on our punt pro and protected well. We protected well on field goal. We kicked and covered excellent on kickoff coverage. Boy, we pinned him down a number of times. You know, kickoff returns were solid. So, you know, we played really well on teams considering the fact that most of these guys aren't coming off the field. I thought it was a pretty impressive effort by the kids, and I was really proud of them. When I brought them back that after the game, we got home at 9 o'clock at night. I had to bring them inside to kind of explain what the course of action was going to be for the rest of the week. But I did also express to them that, you know, there's no moral victories at the University of Delaware. Just that's not the way it's going to be. Am I proud of how hard we played? Absolutely. But we had a chance to beat the number 5 ranked team in the country at their place, and we let that thing get away. We dug ourselves a hole. That's the reality. And now we got to dig ourselves out of this hole. So that's kind of where we're at. They're a little bit like us. They're on their last leg. You know, they know that they need to go get a win. We know that we need to go get a win. We've dug ourselves each a hole, and now we're trying to dig ourselves out of it. And we're throwing dirt on each other, you know, basically. So, because whoever loses this one is kind of playing for moral victories, and you know, that's not what we want to do here.
As far as the whole defense goes, it's nothing we haven't seen before. I mean, they run a 4-2 for the most part. They run a little bit of 3-down, but in general, I think it's just another week. I mean, there's nothing about this defense that jumps out as something that we wouldn't be able to handle or that we would need to adjust in order to take care of.
They have a lot of formations. They do a lot out of these formations. You know, it's a lot of motions, a lot of shifts. It's something that we're really going to have to be on our toes with. You know, lining up is going to be most of the battle this week. So.
Plus, I got a guy who's really good running the football.
Yeah.
That too.
There's the other battle.